The latest on China's COVID wave, President Xi Jinping expresses concern over the virus situation in the Chinese countryside. His remarks come as millions head to China's rural areas for the Lunar New Year celebrations. The Chinese leader urged health authorities to continue addressing shortcomings in their response.
This wave of epidemic came fiercely and fast. All the medical workers have been working on epidemic prevention and control while providing daily medical care at the same time. You have been working long hours, hard and overtime, all for the sake of protecting the life and health of the people. You've made great contributions. Thank you for your efforts.
The tech gloom deepens as Microsoft becomes the latest company to announce a massive layoff. Microsoft will let go 10,000 of its employees in the coming months as it looks to trim costs amid economic uncertainties. The job cuts amount to less than 5% of its global workforce. It follows similar moves by Facebook parent Meta, Amazon, and Twitter. The firings come after a major hiring spree in the tech industry during the pandemic. The Philippine Tourism Department setting a lofty goal of 4.8 million tourist arrivals this year. That's almost double last year's figures of 2.6 million. Tourism Secretary Cristina Frasco says in order to achieve that goal, they're taking a deeper look into the needs of the sector to make it more globally competitive.
Improvements in infrastructure, which is why we're working with the DPWH for this purpose, for the improvement of roads, bridges, drainage systems, water systems in key destinations, improvement of gateway access, digitalization of tourism services, improving internet connectivity in at least 94 destinations all over the Philippines, broken ground on 9 of 10 tourist rest areas all over the country. We've aggressively pursued shared tourism governance to coordinate closely with our local government units.
Meanwhile, Secretary Frasco backs a proposal to implement holiday economics. She says this will boost domestic tourism.
I do understand that there is a need to balance economics with leisure tourism. In the end, however, we also have to examine the employment and livelihood benefits that encouraging domestic tourism can bring. During the pandemic, we saw how much domestic tourism contributed to our economies in the provinces and in the regions. Our president, Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr., passed a proclamation recently to increase long weekends to 9 this year, and this has also stoked a lot of interest and excitement among our fellow Filipinos in terms of booking their trips for 2023.
The Philippine ICT Department is planning to create a so-called super government app. The ICT spokesperson, Ana May Lamentillo, says that is part of the government's efforts to consolidate and digitalize most government services and to make them more accessible to the public. Lamentillo also shares the agency is also pursuing a project with the Interior Department to streamline other processes.
Meron po tayong project with DILG. Ito po yung ILGU system. Integrated local government system. Katuwang nga po ang DILG para ipatupad itong end-to-end business registration sa mga LGU. So kung kailangan po nilang business permit, kumuha ng clearance, real property tax, business tax, civil registry at iba pang permit, yan po yung gusto nating i-roll out.